Oh, dude, you know what I went to last night? Oh, my God. I went to this fucking, this 80s, like, all these bands. This crazy fucking lineup.
Was it the real bands or was it tribute bands?
No, it was like, dude, it was, what was it? Like Drama-Rama. Remember them?
Holy shit.
I can't remember the song. They said Flock of Seagulls, The Romantics.
They were all really there?
Tone Loc.
Oh, my God.
Fucking The Violent Femmes, Melly Mel, then The Furious Five.
Yeah, Furious Five.
And Boy George closed.
No way.
Dude, it was fucking... Where was this? This was at the Microsoft Theater, which used to be the Nokia. Me and Nia went down there, and it was fucking awesome. But I learned a lot about show business watching those people. You could tell... Like, who was sick of singing their hits,
right.
And who was also like, fuck this, I'm bringing it.
Right.
And then I also learned, you know, watching, you know, you got to take care of yourself.
I have a story about that.
Because yeah. I swear to God, dude, if you see a band that let themselves go, it's like depressing. Like yours, because you love them, and they look like shit. And then all you're thinking is like, "Oh my God, I'm fucking 20 years older than he was when he put that song out." We're all gonna die. But when you just see a band come out and they kept themselves in shape and they're fucking killing it, as much as they're older, it's like I'm not gonna name names, but I saw one band that made me think like, "Dude, I'm never drinking again." And then when I saw the Violent Femmes,
yeah.
Like, dude, they just came out and were just a fucking tight, sick-ass band. Like, I watched them. I was like, man, I want to go play drums. I want to practice. I want to get better. Like, there was nothing, like, negative about watching them. They just came out. And they went on after Melly Mel and Furious Five, who fucking killed.
Right.
And you couldn't be more of a different band. Right.
Polar opposites.
Like, literally, the stage would just turn.
Oh, yeah, that's badass. They did that at the iHeartRadio Music Festival thing. They have, like, the stage would rotate 180.
Yeah.
And then they'd have the band, and then they'd do the set dressing behind, and then it would keep turning.
Dude,
badass.
I loved it. They got, like, down in Anaheim, they had it, and, like, Salt and Pepper was on it, and a couple other people. Dude, it was fucking nuts. It was, you just knocked out... like 10 of the bands that I should have seen back then.
Right.
And, you know, they all sounded great. There was just, I'll tell you off, there was just one person that I looked at and it was just like, my God. But he was still singing great, but it's just like, fuck, dude.
Right. See, we saw a Cameo like 6 months ago down, I can't remember, but it was like by the water somewhere here in LA. And Roger Troutman, I remember Roger Blackman, wasn't that? Yeah.
What songs does he sing?
She's on a break.
Oh yeah,
house.
Okay.
Although, dude, he came. You know, because he used to come out in like leather chaps and a cup. You know.
Oh yeah, it was the '70s. Yeah,
right.
Fucking dude, Coke spoon around his neck.
Dude, he's still doing this. Like he came out with the belly. You know, like bad hips and knees, and he's still wearing a cup. But he was like his leather pants in the back looked like a diaper.
Oh.
And he would come out and he just like do this little like trying to be sexy and swivel his hips. And my wife was dying laughing. She was like, he needs to fucking stop.
Yes,
like, stop doing that.
No, but even when you keep yourself in shape.
Yeah, he was not in shape. He was.
You can't do that sexy shit. And that, I'm telling you, that is a self-involved baby boomer thing that is being passed down. Like, dude, Madonna is in unfucking believable shape for her fucking age. But when she starts twerking, it's just Mom, stop it. Right. What are you doing?
Right.
You can't, yeah. And then it's like the older guy. What you got to do is you got to like, I used to talk to DeRosa about this. You know, you got to dress like Dana White.
Right.
When you get older, right? Like Dana White is roughly my age. Dana White, you know, he wears a suit. He wears the collared shirt. Doesn't have the tie.
So
he's a little bit relaxed, but he's dressed like he doesn't look like a creep. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But if he was to show up, you know what I mean? I'm not just putting it on him. I'm just saying that fucking look. But you take a guy the same age, my fucking age, and you're going to try to fucking pull off like a tank top. Like even like when you watch those P90X things, right?
The old guys that are working.
The 58-year-old guys with the abs. It's like, dude, amazing. Put your fucking shirt on.
Right.
Because there's nothing they can do for the loss of elasticity in your fucking skin.
Right.
Yeah, you're decomposing in front of me.
Like with avocado.
Yeah, yeah, they should be. Should be sitting in a giant fruit bowl.
Oh my god!
Little fruit flies flying around you. So I learned a lot. Like I watched those bands, and it was the people that were comfortable with their age and kept themselves in shape and came out and were having a good fucking time.
Hell yeah!
It was just like, oh man, this is fucking great. And you would like, you just were really excited. But if they came out like, you know, they'd fucking, they're still fucking partying like, you know, Keith Richards back in the day, and then they're coming out, and you're gonna still wear like leather and shit.
Right. HDNet had this concert series a couple years ago, and they would show these commercials for the concert series, and they would show, they showed Steppenwolf, right? You don't know what
you can't find. Gonna come with me, little girl. And then that middle section that goes on for fucking ever. Remember, you used to work in a warehouse. That whole fucking the psychedelic part.
Yeah,
goes on for. Sorry, interrupted your story.
That's all right. But they would show like them playing concerts back in like the 70s, and it would be jam-packed arena and people going crazy in the crowd, and then they show them now, like it was smash cut from then to now. Ugh. And now they're playing on like an outdoor stage, and the entire audience of only about 300 people are sitting on this lawn in like lawn chairs watching them. And I'm like,
I know, because we're old
all the people that loved them back then are old now too, so I'm just like watching people perform at like Shady Acres Retirement Community.
I know, but those guys are like 70.
I know, it's fucking.
I'm sure the band still sounds great and everything, but it's got
to
be weird.
Still having fun, or they're just like, fuck, we still have to make money. I'm like,
yeah, well, and a lot of those guys, they got so stolen from and just completely ripped off. And then you add that if somebody got divorced and shit, yeah, you're going to be singing that song.
Ugh.
I just realized I crossed my legs wearing slippers in front of you. I'm sorry.
Those are great slippers.
They are great slippers. No, I finally bought some new socks, and I want to try to keep them white for a while.
Is that a thing for you? That's why I wear black socks.
Oh, that. Well, I can't wear black socks if I have on like dark sneakers though.
Why not?
I mean, I can't wear white socks with dark sneakers. No, I'm sorry. If I have white sneakers, I need white socks.
Really?
Yeah.
I guess. Yeah.
I have mostly white sneakers. No offense.
Okay.
No, but I think a lot of those guys, that's what ends up happening. So I think the way to do it is, and I haven't figured out how to get into the game yet, is you get to a certain point when you're at the height of your earning power. I think you should already be planning your graceful exit from this business, because it's so brutal.
Strategy.
So I think rather than going out and buying flashy shit, fucking hovercraft and all the dumb shit that artists buy.
Right.
Rental units.
Helicopter.
Yeah. I'm not buying a helicopter. I'd love to, but I can't justify
like maintaining it too. It'd be a fucking pain in the ass.
I got a kid now, man. I can't fucking smash cut.